On same topic, meta-analysis of 6 randomized trials was carried out, and that was published in European Heart Journal and discussed in ESC also. 33,000 patients with AMI, mean age was 64, almost 50% had STEMI, and time from MI in this study was 18 months, so people had myocardial infarction 1.5 years back. Prior stroke was there in 3%. So DOPT was continued beyond 1 year, and that was compared with aspirin alone. Follow-up was for 30 months. Primary endpoint was again cardiovascular death, MI stroke, and secondary endpoints were death, MI stroke, non-cardiovascular death, all-cause mortality, major bleeding, and stent thrombosis. Again, primary endpoint was in favor of DAPT. There was significant reduction in all cardiovascular endpoints combined as a composite or even individually. Cardiovascular death was less, myocardial infarction was less, stroke was less, and stent thrombosis was also significantly less with extended DAPT beyond 1 year. As expected, again, major bleeding was more. But same thing, ICH was no different, fatal bleeding was no different, non-cardiovascular death was also no different, and all-cause death was also not different. So basically, probably bleeding was more GI bleed rather than any other major significant bleed. So conclusion from this trial or message was this, that in patients with prior MI who are at low risk of bleeding, continuing DAPT beyond 1 year offers substantial reduction in major adverse cardiac as well as cerebrovascular events, including cardiovascular death, had increased risk of bleeding, but there was no fatal bleeding, no increased ICH, there was no excess of non-cardiovascular death, and effect of extended DAPT was consistent irrespective of DAPT regimen, so whether you give any of the three molecules, time from MI, type of MI, and whether patient had undergone PCI or no, everywhere benefit was clearly seen. So guidelines have changed. European guidelines say that in selected patients who are at low risk of bleeding and high risk of ischemic recurrent event, you can give DAPT for prolonged period, and SEC has given it as a class 2B indication already. Now what about reperfusion injury during STEMI? It is a paradox. You open the closed artery and you get increased infarct size. So there is no specific treatment target for myocardial reperfusion injury. Now what is this myocardial reperfusion injury? See, this is a cell, myocardial cell, and this is mitochondrium. Now there is something called permeability transition port in the mitochondrial inner membrane. And what happens that during reperfusion, this port opens. And then it causes cytochrome C release, and cytoplasm also goes inside the mitochondrium, and that leads to cell death or what we call apoptosis. And the molecule cyclophilin D actually helps the opening of this pore. So if we inhibit this cyclophilin D, then there may be reduction in opening of this pore and cell death. So cyclosporine is a substance which is inhibitor of cyclophilin D, which actually may reduce this reperfusion injury. That is the concept.